My name is Janice Haupt Allen, and I've lived in Las Vegas for 56 years, going on 57. I had a love affair of Las Vegas since 1947, when I saw a Life magazine two-page article, and it was about Las Vegas, and it showed a stagecoach going down the street, and I thought, oh, I loved cowboy movies when I was a child, and I thought, that's really exciting. I was 19 years old at the time. And so we were going to get married, and my fiance said, where would you like to go to get married or on your honeymoon? What would you like? I want to go to Las Vegas. I saw Betty Grable and Harry James getting married at the Little Church of the West, and I thought, that's where I want to go. Well, that was 2,500 miles away, but he happened to have a little plane, and so we started planning, and everybody thought we were crazy to come out to Las Vegas. But as soon as we flew into the West and I saw the Grand Canyon and the beautiful mountains, and I thought, oh, this is heaven. So we landed in Las Vegas at Alamo Airways. It was owned by George Crockett, and it was a dirt runway. And it was one of those typical Las Vegas windy days. And as we landed, the wind was blowing, and this little red Jeep came out to our plane and said, hi. Welcome to Las Vegas, follow me. And that was Peg Crockett, pioneer in aviation. All the old timers were in the JCS, the Cashmans and the Montobles. Everybody of the old timers belonged to the sororities. And when I was president of the city council, there were 18 chapters. And they were all, everybody in town that you knew was in one of the chapters. And we had great social events, and we put on fashion shows for charities, and we kind of governed them, and we put on the rituals when the people would can be joining and everything. And I enjoyed that year very much. And it's the same year they all the chapters voted for their chapter girl of the year. And then they had a panel pick the citywide girl of the year. And that 1958, then I was the first one they ever had. From that, then I went right into the junior league, which was the service league. And that was another organization that's been around a long time. And the one that Florence Lee Kalin, Jones Kalin, was the first and second president. And I've been president twice, active president once in 66, 67, and then sustainer president, that's the older girls over 40, 76, 77, and I'm still active. And we do the Sun Youth Forum registering since it began, and that's next year is 50 years. In the early days, we started a mentally retarded nursery. And we had it at the Episcopal Church. And then we brought in the John Tracy Clinic. And I got the first equipment donated for hearing for children, audiological testing equipment. And I got the leg to pay for it. And I used to have bus tours where I'd take people on going to all the special ed schools. And we helped the blind and we helped the deaf and all that. So I think my life's always been a lot for helping, and you know, children in all ways that I can. Well, I just did my 43rd year on the Sun Youth Forum, and I was a moderator for over 20 years, and I've been charge of registration, and will through their 50th year, and I'm on the board of the and board of trustees of the Las Vegas Art Museum. And so I'm very excited about that, and I plan to give my clock collection to the museum. I think I'm going to be more of a philanthropist in my old age, because I feel like there's a lot of things that need to be done, and you can't take it with you.